Monerotopia weekly news segment is sponsored by iVPN. Use a VPN to help prevent your online activity from becoming a permanent record. iVPN encrypts your data and DNS requests so your ISP or mobile network provider cannot monitor or log your online activity. Purchase an iVPN service today anonymously with Monero.
There you go. Right now, it's time for the news section. But before we begin, because we have a lot of interesting stuff to talk about, make sure that you buy your tickets if you haven't for Monerotopia 2023, which is going to be next week in Mexico City. Use code Tony and you're going to get a discount. Now let's get into the news section. So this is a pie chart based on the first week of enabling XMR purchases via Payfura. And this is the percentage of XMR purchased by country. So number one is Sweden. Number two is UK. And they account for half of the transactions. Over half, 56.8%. Then there's China, number three, Denmark, France, Ireland, Austria, Australia, Slovakia, and Brazil. So very interesting that Sweden and the UK account for 56.8% of the transactions. Then CakeWallet had an update. Monero.com had an update. You have a way to easily restore wallets from QR code, which is very nice. A new on-ramper buy widget, a type of fiat amount in the receive screen. Bitcoin lighting invoices in exchange, substantially better reliability for seeing incoming unconfirmed Bitcoin account transactions. So a lot of stuff. So make sure that you update your Cake wallet, your Monero.com wallet, and use it. I updated mine, so it's all ready to go. Now I want to show you guys the video of a farmer in France and selling his beautiful vegetables and nutritious vegetables for Monero. Scan his Cake wallet, boom, paid peer-to-peer, vegetables done, he left, that's it. If you can do that, if you can purchase your groceries or whatever you want to buy peer-to-peer, which will be nice and ideal, and I try. And one time I was able to buy coconut water with Doug and Sunita in Miami, which is really, very nice. Peer-to-peer, that was before the gift cards, but now you have gift cards. So you can purchase a gift card via the app, and you can purchase whatever you want. You can go to Adidas, you can buy groceries, you can buy prepaid Visa, you can do a lot of stuff. Nike, whatever. It's really nice. Then let's get into surveillance now. So basically the US wants to pass a bill in which your social media apps, whatever you use to message your friends and family, that's going to be tied to the Drug Enforcement Administration. And this is in the name of catching illegal drug sales, right? A lot of people, they joke about using drugs. Maybe they talk about past drug usage. I don't think there's a lot of people that, from all the people that talk on these apps, that actually are selling the drugs. With that being said, them being a minority, with what I think, they're using this as an excuse to crack down on your privacy and to basically just spy on what you're reading, because they're not going to just stop at, oh, cocaine, okay, let's go on that conversation. Oh, that's interesting. Why they're saying that? It's not ideal, and they're using this excuse. So they want to surveil your communications with other people. Then they want to surveil your finances. So a US regulator says that crypto must end anonymity for illicit finance. First of all, there's only one that is truly anonymous, which is Monero. The other ones are not really anonymous, especially because everybody buys them on Coinbase. So they're directly tied. They're pseudo-anonymous, like Bitcoin, Dogecoin, whatever, but they're tied to your identity, social security number, passport, all this stuff. So, it's really just Monero, because they can crack all the other ones down, chain analysis and all these companies, Elliptic, they can, track you down. And they're doing very well at it. So yeah, but essentially, they don't want you to have privacy. Now the EU and the US are working on regulations on crypto, of course, to make it safe again for illicit activities, blah blah, which of course I don't want any illicit activities to happen in the world. All the bad stuff, trafficking and all the stuff, it's horrible. Of course nobody wants it, but they're using that as an excuse to just surveil your whole life, your messaging, your finances, and then what's next? Your house. They're going to put, 1984, in which you're going to have cameras in your house so that they can see if you're doing anything illegal in your own house, like growing weed or whatever, right? I hope it's not going to come at that point, because that'll be crazy. But people are still going to comply, probably. They're going to say, oh, yeah, you know, it's to catch bad guys. Right. But in the same time, you have handcuffs all the time. The EU is doing actually pretty good when it comes to regulation compared to the US. They've been working on MiCA since 2020, so it's been a couple of years. So they're working very hard towards it. But there's one Article 68 that raises concerns. What is Article 68? Article 68 essentially addresses the rules for operating a trading platform for crypto assets, right? Essentially, the trading platform shouldn't allow holders of the assets to have built-in anonymization, which is horrible for businesses and individuals. Because as a business, you want to have your practices private. You don't want anybody to see how much you pay your employees, what you do with your money as a business. That shouldn't be a thing. And also as an individual, nobody should really see what you do unless you tell them to, right? So this article from Forbes is talking about privacy. You know, it's a concern that MiCA is not going to really address. And they're going to make it so that people are going to think, okay, well, I'm just might as well use the digital euro, unless I guess you want to escape inflation, then you'll turn to crypto or some cryptos. But other than that, it's just going to be like a digital surveillance system, and crypto is not really a revolution anymore, unless something like Monero, which is not on a lot of trading platforms. And I wonder if it's going to be the platform on Kraken eventually. I mean, in Kraken UK you can't buy it anymore, but let's talk about Bitcoin privacy war. I'm not going to get into details on this because obviously it's a very long discussion, and we'll be talking about it for a long time, but I'm just going to summarize. Basically, there's two wallets, Samurai and Wasabi wallet, right? And they have different practices, but they both have their problems. Wasabi, they decided to blacklist transactions. So what level of privacy do you really have? Not full privacy. And Samurai, they have their issues as well, such as not enabling the Tor tool by default. So you need to flip the switch. If the user doesn't know about that, you can expose your IP address with Samurai wallet. So they both have their issues. They've both been going at each other. They both implement new things. People don't like it. Take it back, whatever. Very, very long discussion. If you want to read this article or any other articles that we have discussed today, you can go in the description and see it for yourself. But yeah, it's a very long discussion, but it's very interesting. And I wonder how Bitcoin's privacy is going to evolve over time, and where it's going to be, and what level of privacy are you going to get. But Monero standing as the standard for ultimate privacy, protecting absolutely everybody, every single person. Let's talk about Hamas. Hamas is basically, it's a Palestinian militant group. I'm not sure if it's a Okay, it's listed as a terrorist organization by the US and UK. Okay, so terrorist organization according to their standards. But they are not accepting Bitcoin donations anymore. They used to, because they want to protect the donors. And we've seen what happened to Canada. They identified the people that donated and went after them. So they care about the people, they care about the donors, and they're not accepting Bitcoin transactions anymore. In 2021, Israeli officials seized 84 digital wallets suspected of belonging to Hamas. Then they had Bitcoin Doge, basically not Monero. but if they do learn about Monero, they can use Monero and accept Monero donations, and nobody would even know. So that's the beautiful part. Last thing that I want to discuss is European bankers on digital euro. The ECB has no interest in users' personal data, which is a lie, because they do have interest in users' personal data. You can go back to earlier episodes where we talked a little bit about their vision of privacy in the ECB, and they basically said, we'll have privacy, but not really. I mean, we'll still be able to see everything that you do. But the private banks raise questions to this new system. So you have the banks versus the government. So this is what the article talks about. The central bank digital money could threaten the traditional bank's business model by competing with their collection activity and disrupting their financial capacity. They should therefore not consider the provision of digital euro services as a sort of obligation, but should explore the economic potential by developing competing for creative solutions. Basically, banks don't like it. They say they should use it as a they should limit that as a payment, but not really as a store of value. So very interesting how the banks and the governments are going head to head. We had an article about Russia and their banks versus the government going head to head, essentially not really agreeing. But yeah, it's going to be an interesting development. And they do have an interesting, the ECB does have an interest in your personal data, and you're not going to have much privacy. You can read the legislation and everything for yourself that Christine Lagarde put up, and we've discussed in earlier episodes. So yeah, this was a new section, but before we end it, let's actually go to monerotopia.com, guys. This is the last time we're going to do it, which is crazy. It's been a year. It's been a year since last year's conference, but it's going to be on, my phone is not here, May 5th through May 7th. And it hasn't been loading. I know we've been getting DDoS attacks for the past 3 days, which is crazy. People don't want us to succeed, but we are going to succeed. It's working. Good. Okay, now it's working, kind of, sort of. The images are not loading, but that's okay. So you add to cart, you view the cart, guys. This is the last thing that I'll mention. And you put Tony, then you apply the coupon, and you still get 21% off, $78. It's next week. Make sure you buy it. Make sure you go. We have a lot of people. But yeah, this was the new section, everybody. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you, I think, next week. But I mean, next week is going to be crazy. So we'll see.